Hi everybody, my name is Angela Costantini and I'm here to represent Comprehensive Institute 3 in Modena, an Italian school that in the last 3 years has made great efforts in order to become more international. In this presentation, I'm going to share our experience. Well, it is impossible to fit so many ideas and stories into a 10-12 minutes presentation. I will do my best, and I'm going to focus our attention on 5 points. Number one, our eTwinning story, school involvement and personal experience. Number two, our Erasmus opportunity for traveling as teachers. Number three, Erasmus projects with students traveling around Europe. Number four, setbacks and achievements. Number five, conclusions. Let's start with number one, eTwinning. As you have just heard from our principal, one of the main goals of internationalization is language learning, effective, natural language learning, speaking different languages in order to communicate. Communication creates connection, and connection sounds like twinning, e-twinning. Our adventure with internationalization started in 2017. We were awarded the e-twinning label and invited to participate at the annual e-twinning conference in Rome. Since then, in our school's interest in e-twinning projects has increased year after year. In 2017, for example, we started with one only simple project, Christmas traditions in Italy. The following year, the projects became three, Christmas card exchange, 2 teachers and 5 classes. Then 2 projects in 2018, English is in the Air and A Funny School Year, have been awarded the quality label. Our engagement was still growing in 2019. 10 classes and 3 schools were participating in e-twinning activities. 2 schools, Rodari and King, joined in a fascinating project called Christmas and Coding. Noel and Poesie involved several classes at their secondary school. 3 classes joined in the project Water Cycle, but then we all know what happened in 2019. The activities have been interrupted due to the COVID pandemic. This year, 2020-2021, several projects are taking place. Intelligence and skill games, around the world in 80 days, our Easter traditions and many more. Anyway, I would like to talk about 3 projects in particular. Let's start with Noel and Poesie that was carried out by a secondary school French teacher. Her 11-year-old students partook in an e-twinning project where the communication activities were entirely held in French. For this project, the students created Christmas greetings cards and exchanged them with the other classes. Each card contained greetings and a poem about Christmas from the origin country of the participants. The language used was different according to each country the students were from. Each card was accompanied by a translation in French for a reciprocal understanding. The different phases of the project were the following: collective reading of different poems and selection of the favorite ones, a collective translation of the text in French, comprehension and rewriting tasks through different exercises, card reading, decoration and creative illustration of the cards. In December 2019, students met the author of one of the chosen poems, Roberto Piumini, and they could tell him about their work with the twinning. The second project involving children from 4 to 11 years old was A Funny School Year. Partners shared some special moments of their school life. the first day of school, welcoming activities at the beginning of the school year, celebrations of festivities such as Christmas, Easter, Mother's Day, Sports Day, and any other event that we usually organize at school. A page was created for each school in which teachers could share photos, videos, drawings, short text presentations. At the end of the school year, every school created a video with the special moments lived and activities carried out. All the videos have been uploaded on an interactive map of Europe and shared with the partners. Besides, a collaborative book was created too, with the photos of each class and a short list of the activities shown in the video. The project was awarded the quality label in 2018. The third project I would like to talk about is the one I am currently participating in, Let the Books Speak. The basic idea is to create many talking books in many different languages to allow blind children to better appreciate books and stories. My colleague Aizen, project co-founder, in fact, had previously worked in a school for blind children. In Italy, not only we do read for blind children, but also the disabled kids can contribute by recording a small piece of reading. For example, the disabled pupil of our class inserts some words. The ones he knows, his classmates appreciate his contribution so much. It is a way to enhance diversity and inclusion. Each month, a teacher from a different country suggests a story. Children read a piece of the story, record it, and send the video to the teacher, who combines the images of the readers with the book illustrations. In some cases, children also create drawings. Within a few days, the children hear and watch the same story in many languages: Turkish, Bulgarian, Ukrainian. Moreover, we can have a personal insight into their everyday lives. We see the bedrooms of our companions from all over Europe. We can see their equipment, the recording situation, sometimes from the kitchen table. Okay, number two, our Erasmus opportunity for traveling. In 2018, we won the Erasmus Plus project, and 19 teachers from our institute visited several schools in Europe: England, Finland, Germany, Greece, Spain. We could choose between job shadowing or training in English courses. Traveling is always a great experience. It helps us become more open-minded. We have seen several ways to teach, effective methods, nice and kind colleagues. Sometimes, beyond the first appearance, we realized that we were not so different anyway. We have collected all our travel memories in this blog. Someone went to Oxford for an English course, and this is his report. Here you can see a job shadowing experience in Germany, a couple of videos by our colleague Spain, Zamora. Six teachers went to Finland, very nice group. And this is my post, a couple of videos about my STEAM education course in Heraklion, Crete. Fantastic. Well, I can't show you everything. There are 19 posts and each one is so interesting, but it's too time consuming to share everything right now. So, have a look at our fantastic blog. The link will be available to those who are interested. We have prepared all these contributions for a dissemination event that took place the following year, altogether in Mattarella School, the Bring Your Mug event. And again here, this time it was an online event due to COVID pandemic. This experience was very meaningful for us. Not only did we visit schools in different countries, but it was also a wonderful opportunity to get to know each other better. Among us, teacher of the Comprehensive Institute, the combination of travelers have in fact allowed the teachers of different school grades to spend a week together. Number three, Erasmus projects with students traveling around Europe. Three Erasmus projects involving students aged 11 to 15 were excellent opportunities to work together primary and secondary schools. Erasmus Plus KA229 Tech, Technology Enhanced Classroom. It's a two-year project whose main objective is the development of key competences for lifelong learning, in particular intercultural expression and language learning through the use of technology. The project involves 5 trips for students and teachers to Sweden, Iceland, the United Kingdom and Spain. The students were involved in environmental activism carried out with a rigorous scientific perspective thanks to STEAM methodologies. Issues related to negative stereotypes and gender differences were also addressed. The project involved Mattarella, Rodari and King School. The project is continuing, but remotely. Erasmus KA229GNS Green New Schools. It's a two-year project that has, as its main objective, the cooperation between European countries with the aim of promoting innovation and the exchange of good practices regarding environmental protection. The project proceeds remotely online due to the COVID pandemic. Number 4, setbacks and achievements. The bigger problem when it comes to internationalization and innovation in general is the lack of continuity. Some teachers adopt innovative processes, but it's hard to extend them to the rest of the institute. Joining an e-twinning project requires a basic, well, maybe more than basic, knowledge of a second language, English usually. And not all teachers are able to understand or speak English. Secondly, often e-twinning partners are quite confident with technology and ask everybody to use several different apps. This can be stressful for teachers who are just learning to use the digital school register or the Google Apps. We already have our class problems. Parents complaining, students who can't learn how to write and read. It's hard to raise our eyes, overcome our small problems, our narrow reality, and look for a bigger purpose. It's hard, but it's so important. When a small group of teachers strongly believes in internationalization, the idea will extend, slowly but gradually. Our headmaster always says that we must open up our classrooms and broaden our sight. We understand that we must insist day by day to create a common mindset in our 4 schools. These experiences have been extremely beneficial for both teachers and students. Our students learned about different traditions, different ways of living, and could practice their skills in the language they are studying, English or French. In conclusion, internationalization is a teaching principle that facilitates mutual understanding, helps recognize differences and similarities, and reduce prejudice. The e-twinning platform provides factual possibilities to meet different cultures and different school systems. We are all enthusiastic about these experiences, which definitely widen our horizons and help us work in a more active and engaging way. All the challenges facing us are global. COVID pandemic made it painfully obvious. Global warming is global. Our future is global. The title of this presentation is Europe is my home, but we all understand that the world is our only home. Thank you for having us.